Right, now I'll go over a game that I just played. The finish was pretty nice. Already this move I kind of disliking. I feel like red should either play e3 or knight f3. And the reason is basically that after knight f3 you can develop the queen, and the bishop is protected, so you're not in a checkmating threat, and also the knight covers your back row, so there's no real, like, imagine the queen moves, I move the k7, and then there would be a bishop m7, depending the mate, and that would mean disaster, like the green queen could be a desperado piece against the possibly the red queen going out somewhere. This move is reasonable, but I think it's a little bit inaccurate. I just developed my queen. One trick here is that if I try to develop my queen, I mean I can go all the way, but let's say I try this. This one does not work because of bishop take and now normally we would move the pawn and I would checkmate, but now the red bishop is in the way. And after takes, there is queen defends the queen. What? Yeah. And now if you take this, there's no way to defend this queen. Yeah, that's the tactical justification. I mean, you can also say that because if you play the defending move like this and then takes queen i3, queen takes h12, queen takes, and now you can play this move. And the bishop is not in place to stop it. So in fact, here the same thing is, this queen move is forced. Then it's trouble. That's why you have to play this bishop move before. And now it's basically over. So this bishop move does stop the main idea by blue to develop the queen, but I'm not really that keen on developing my queen. I find that if I just develop my pieces, the queen will come out afterwards, especially if your teammate is playing somewhat confidently. Right, so we pushed the pawn. I don't really like this move. I think you should prepare to bring the queen out, but it's not a problem this move. You could be aggressive here and just bring the queen out. I could even capture this pawn. But I think that's a little bit risky after something like e12. Yeah, so just normal moves, and that this is why I like playing d6 and k9. because then you're op you have your options open after you play k9, knight l6, then you have the option of playing either l7 or l8. Whereas if you play this variation, you're really never going to play l7, at least not in the first 20 minutes. Or if you want to lose, that is. And I feel like this setup is somewhat cramping, because red and yellow played such cramping moves, but on the other hand, my teammate green has free development pretty much. And here I think I could play bishop b8, but it wasn't feeling correct. I think the bishop should stay home, and I just move the rook. So now there's no fork after multiple bishop captures. And he brings the queen out. So now green has the active queen. I think this is a mistake. This knight is not going anywhere, and it's kind of justifying my rook move. And my bishop stays on a nice diagonal. I think it was time to bring the queen out. I'm not sure where, maybe queen j4. Yeah. And here he took. And this is the final blunder of the game. But it was really hard there. The best move is probably to play queen k5. The idea is that after queen takes bishop, queen f14, there is the saver queen d12, blocking off the bishop, and in the end this should be 3-4. Are you up a piece here? No, wait. 23. Ah, so we're up a piece. How did that happen? Yeah, right, because I captured a bishop. That's funny. Yeah, so this was just good. This was already pretty hard, if you ask me. And now that I look at it again, I'm pretty sure it's just losing. The best move is probably still this. Queen k5. Queen takes c9. Queen takes c9, queen f14, and queen c12. Takes probably knight k4. Yeah, I think knight k4. And now you just have to develop something. I don't know, let's say knight h2. I want to play bishop b10. What I was worried about was something like... I mean, the only thing I was worried about was playing queen d10, pinning my rook. Now check. Probably king runs. If you're really, really bold, you could move the king. That was a joke. Checkmate. It's coming. So I would probably just move my knight. Next, play knight b8, defending the rook, and then prepare to move the bishop. What am I talking about? This movie is just blundering the queen. There you see. Check. Picking up the queen. Yeah. Didn't see that one. So this should be really strong then. I'm not sure what to play. Maybe this one. Good idea to enter. I mean, how can this be good? I don't think it can be. And also, there was some other tricks here. You could even play a funny looking move there. No. Yeah, this is just over actually. So, when the best line is giving up a piece, then you know you're in some trouble. This opening was really not that great from red and yellow. Moving your bishops in the opening is really problematic unless you have temple moves. Alright, let's go to the game. And the queen sack. Now the interesting variation is not yellow capturing the queen, because that hangs mate in one. I thought, I mean, there is still a mate there, but the prettiest variation is when green ignores the mate. So probably the best move would be something like knight f12. Just saying, yeah, we lost it. But what if queen f12? Now there is a mate here, and it's queen f14, and the queen cannot block my bishop, so that's a checkmate. But let's just ignore that for a moment, shall we? And if you can't play queen f14, what do you play? Because, you know, queen f6 is covered. So if red gets another move, then he just takes my queen. It's not easy. Actually, there might be more than one win here, but the prettiest and definitely the cleanest. Queen takes j2. Now, what's funny is that after queen takes queen, then I get to save my queen, and we have a winning position. So the really interesting one is what happens if you grab my queen. And then I play e6. Now there's a checkmate threat on red. So yellow's only move is to block. But the problem is that now green just captures red's queen, and his rook is still hanging. And there's also a mating threat on yellow, so be careful. Now, I don't know what to suggest. Probably the best is just to develop something, but let's say you save your rook, then I just take the queen, and rear up a lot of material with a winning attack. Let's say knight out. I don't know. I might go for some shenanigans here. Yeah. What about... Yeah, so I have some tricks here. This one, for example? That's funny. Probably red should block this, yeah? I play the bishop or not? Yeah, and then he captures. That was a bummer. Yeah, I shouldn't be so extravagant, let's say. Yeah, just play a normal move. I don't know. Bring the bishop out. Say that one. Now, if I could capture, then it would be really great. So, I don't know. Maybe play here. Yeah, I think so. Bishop J8. Now, yellow is really feeling it. The attack, I mean. You really have to cover your king because knight e10 doesn't work because of queen g13. Now what? Let's say you just move the pawn. Now you're preparing to cut off the king even more. Let's say some random knight development. I'm pretty sure I will play something. Oh no, it doesn't work. Okay. This knight move was too good. Too good. Oh, now I capture, of course. Okay. The rook is hanging. Ready to play. Let us say he attacks that one. Oh, that's just bad. Check and check. So you don't do that. Capture. K4. Yeah, and rook f10. Rook f14. And just attack the rook. Actually, this move must be good. Yeah, that's pretty clean. I'm not sure what you play there. It's already quite desperate at this point. Yeah, let's just say you attack the knight. Now I'm looking at some developing moves, and I think my h14 is first, which is sad. Yeah, and now you just attack, threaten checkmate. Let's say it takes. You block the mate, but takes. That must be ugly. Oh, there's a counter check. That's too bad. Now this is good. You take the bishop. And now, take. Yeah, just take this. You have enough. Check. Just run. Now take. Check. Funny business. That was the idea. Now you can choose how to mate. That's not very interesting. Yeah, so let's jump to the finish. Oh, did I overwrite it? Yeah. And this was the game. It was just a quick finish. That was checkmate. But I thought the really pretty variation was when you allowed the green to take on J2. Yeah, thanks for watching.